tonight we're having a showdown between my Aunt Kim and Hillary. Top of the morning, friends and family. Welcome to Music Monday. If you're brand new to the channel, Music Monday is the day we pick out songs that we like, and songs that we think are gonna go well with the channel, and just making sure that's there so I can track my little vlog thing off of it. And welcome. Well, did I say welcome? Welcome again. I'm gonna bring you guys through my morning routine. Almost every morning of my life, I come down to the snake room, and I clean whatever snakes need to be cleaned. It doesn't get old because I get to check out the cool snakes along the way. And I would like you guys to leave a comment down below and let me know how many snakes you think are gonna need to be cleaned today. Yes, cleaned. Just to give you an idea, there are exactly 54 snakes in this room right now. So that's, there can't be more than 54 snakes that need to be cleaned. That's my point. So go ahead, leave a comment down below. I will wait, we'll see how many snakes you think. Don't cheat and wait till we see, actually see. Just leave a comment right now. How many snakes do you think are gonna need cleaning today? Okay, I hope you have your comment down there. After we finish cleaning, I've also got a snake that's due to have a clutch here. She was actually due to lay 2 days ago, so she's beyond past due. So while we're cleaning, we'll check out that and see if she has a clutch, hopefully. And then Hillary is accepting a challenge of her own today. We're gonna watch her do her challenge and see what happens with that. Also, with my own challenge, I've been filming pretty much every day. I'm making a compilation of footage, so at the very end of the challenge I can do a montage so we can all see exactly what I did along the way to win this challenge. Like, I'm going to win this challenge. I mean, it's not even a question. I don't understand why some of you... No, it's all right. It's all right. Every team needs to have a team. We can't have nobody on somebody's team, so I get it. You gotta pick a team. We can't all be on Team Cusco, and then otherwise there'd be no contest, even though there's really no contest. But, aside from that, let's get clean as snakes, guys. Gears Pied had some stuck shed, so I sprayed her down, misted her down, got her on this side, creating a little hot box in here, getting a little steam room action so I can easily pull that stuff off her. Well, I say easily, it's not gonna be the easiest thing in the world, but gotta get that shed off her, so we'll do that in a little bit. But par for the course, I am sweating my butt off and have only cleaned 3 snakes so far. It's not every morning that all 5 retics are needing to be cleaned, but it's not uncommon either, so. Halo needs a cleaning too, so we're at 5. If you haven't commented down below yet as far as how many snakes are gonna be cleaned today, you're cheating! You can't. One more rack to go, and we've cleaned 17 out of 54 snakes so far. If you haven't left your comment down below and you guess, you are really, really screwing with the honor system. You know who's waiting until we finish? Miguel at Always Evolving Pythons. He's waiting until we finish so he can put down the right number. And now he's gonna change it to a wrong number just so he doesn't think, yeah. I know what you're doing over there, bro. Ooh. We're not gonna count this as having to clean. But that looks like a lock. If I ever saw a lock in my life, I tell you what, that's a lock right there. I tell you what, that's Lesser. That's Bullwinkle and Bernice. Doing the thing, getting it done, making it happen. Breeding is a messy, messy, dirty business, so we're not gonna count that. We're not gonna count that. We're not cleaning that. We're leaving them alone. There's where Bullwinkle usually stays up there. He's clean. Oh, discrepancy. You know, dropping a camera is a huge part of my filmmaking process. Oh, I love that. Dirty water, that counts. Here, have some extra humidity, my guy. All right, we're down to Candace. Let's see. Let's see if we got a clutch in there. Clutch, hoping for a clutch, hoping for a clutch, hoping for a clutch, 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 clutch. Oh man, she's gonna lay any moment though. Don't worry, as soon as she lays, I will film myself pulling the clutch. I promise you that. I'm not gonna bother them, not gonna bother them. Last snake. Master. I almost forgot the corn snakes. We're at 20. Hey, if you commented down below already and then you deleted it, I still got the notification, so I'm on to you. Man, that corn snake poop is no joke. Okay, for real now. The last snake. Moment of truth. We're at 21. Oh man, look at that. Man, 22 out of 54 snakes. That's like over a third. That's actually kind of high. It's usually not quite that many. I don't usually keep track. I just come down and clean, so I have no idea how many snakes I usually clean. 22. Okay. Maybe I'll start keeping track. I hope you guys enjoyed the Metallica. I am a huge fan of Metallica. I know a lot of people either like seem to love them or hate them, but if you listen to their lyrics, I mean, that's one huge part why I love them. They're also the group that I played guitar to the most when I was learning how to play guitar. Kirk Hammett's licks and all his solos, that was like my bread and butter for learning how to play guitar. And I've actually got a Metallica story for you guys. So I used to live fairly close to Kirk Hammett actually in Hawaii. And one time we were playing a show. It was like a New Year's Eve party on the beach in Waimanalo, and it was just New Year's Eve or New Year's celebration, and it was just a little after midnight, and we were actually going into a cover of All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix style, and Kirk Hammett comes strolling up the beach with a bottle of champagne and a cigar, and I was just like, I saw him stroll up and just kind of stand there, started watching his play, and I almost stopped playing. I didn't. I kept the beat, kept it going, but I almost stopped. And I was like, that's Kirk Hammett. He's standing on the beach here in Waimanalo watching us play All Along the Watchtower. And it was pretty cool. We ended up hanging out with him for a little while afterwards. And that was probably his second bottle of champagne at that point, I think. He was definitely feeling it. That was cool. But where the story gets really cool is like, two, maybe 3 months later, I was up on North Shore. We had a family day up there. We're getting in the water and stuff. And there's this little natural food store up there in Haleiwa that is a little hole-in-the-wall type of place, but it's got really good food. And so I walk in there, and sure enough, standing in front of me in line, there he is, Mr. Hammett. And I'm standing there, I'm like, dude, should I say something? He probably doesn't even remember who I am. He was drunk. And then he turns around and looks at me, and he goes, hey, you playing that band, don't you? And I wanted to die at the spot. They're talking about the guy that I looked up to learning how to play guitar. huge world touring famous heavy metal band, turned around in line to store, looks at me and says, "Hey, don't you play in that band?" that was my moment as a musician. Like that was it right there. Anyway, let's get Hillary on her challenge.
I said I'm beating you again tonight?
No.
So back before we had these folks back here. Yeah. Hillary and I, we traveled a lot. We went places. We did things together. We went on a really amazing trip one time to Europe. We spent 3 months traveling around Europe. Part of me wishes that I was vlogging during that time, because there were some epic moments. I guess some moments are better formed memories off camera, but man, it would have been fun. It would have been fun to vlog over in Europe a little bit, huh? Captured? She's not sure. She's not 100% sure.
I mean, there would have been some awesome footage, but I think it, like, being there just to experience it all as our focus, it would have taken away from that a little bit. Because then it might have been like, oh, let's go there because it'll be great for the vlog, rather than like, let's just see where the wind takes us, because that's pretty much what we did. But
well, at least I did bring a camera, so when we got to go to places like Rome and
Zermatt
with the Matterhorn,
Interlaken,
yes, with the lakes and the hiking up to the high mountains and skydiving off the side of a cliff, and yeah, that was some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah.
But the reason I'm bringing this up is there was one place in Switzerland, the hostel we were staying, and in the back of that hostel there was a little ping pong table, and Hillary and I would play tennis from time to time. To be fair, to be honest, we're fairly evenly matched. I like to think I win a little more than she does, but when it came to table tennis, apparently, it's not that I'm bad. I can play ping pong. I can hit the ball back pretty quickly. And she was just destroying me. It was not even cool. I got very frustrated. I didn't get necessarily angry, but I was definitely frustrated. I was irritated that I could not beat her at ping pong. And so we were here at my uncle's house, which is where we're headed to right now, the other night, and we're playing again, and she beat me again. And my Aunt Kim got word of this, so tonight we're having a showdown between my Aunt Kim and Hillary to see who is the better ping pong player, because we've heard that both are supposedly good. I've got my money on Hillary, to be honest. I've never seen Aunt Kim play ping pong. She is married to my Uncle Dave, who is the ping pong playing champion in our family. Everybody in our family knows Uncle Dave is the ping pong.
Then why am I not playing Dave? No, I am a little scared to play Dave. I could see him being really good at it.
Uncle Dave is the best ping pong player.
No, Mommy. Mommy's the best ping pong player in the family.
What's she doing? Hey, Moosh. What do you know?
I know more than you think.
Alright, this is going down. This is happening right now. What do we got? What do we got? Who's gonna win? Alright, you gotta leave a comment down below. Who's gonna win? Hillary?
You're going down.
Or Auntie Kim? I wanna know. Who do you think is gonna win?
You're going down, down, Blondie.
You're going to.
Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dreams. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. Cause your life will depend on the strength that you have inside you. Oh, you gotta be proud, staring out in the crowd when the odds in the game defy you. Try your best to win them all, and one day time will tell. When you're the one that's standing there, you reach the final bell.
Focus your game, girl. Stop cracking up over here. Stop losing your crap. Keep it together. Mikey, it's getting intense. Who do you think's gonna win?
Me.
97?
Keep this together. You got this. Don't give up now.
I need a motion to get.
You're in the lead. You got this. Come on, Team Costco. How does it feel to be victorious?
You know, if it's good, but I kind of had a feeling it was going to happen. What can I say?
Small taste of what it feels like to get beat by Team Cusco. Well, you're going to be seeing a lot more of that happening in the next couple months, I think. I guess Auntie Kim she's a Cusco technically, so she got Team Cusco so good it beats itself.
Don't you know it, fool, you know how we do it. With the homie smelling a bud.
What do you know?
I know. Trees.
What about trees?
That they're big.
Yeah.
And I don't know anything else.
Hey, Noah.
What?
What do you know?
I know cars.
What about cars?
That they have horns. Like this. Oh, and watch out, cause let me see if I can go. And then I'll do levers. This is how you go. Or look, look. Watch me do this.
So I've toyed with the idea of just letting her have the shed stay stuck on the back of her neck and her back and just let it come off with the next one, hopefully, or let her rub it off on her own after some soaking. But I kind of want to get it off. The reason I'm hesitant is because she's just such a stress case and I don't want to stress her out too much. And I don't really want to get bit by her, which is almost inevitable. I do have these gloves. Make fun of me all you want, but I play guitar. My fine motor skills in my fingers are very important to me. I don't want to suffer nerve damage there, so also, I don't want her to think that biting me is gonna stop me from messing with her. So if she goes ahead and bites my hands all she wants, then maybe that'll also help her realize that biting me is not gonna change anything that's happening. So, I don't know, it's what it is. I'm just gonna try and help her out and hopefully neither of us will stress out from it too much.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. And long last love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Caught in the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you.
I want to.
I know there's undoubtedly a few of you out there that was just kind of hoping I was going to get bit. Sorry to disappoint you, but I think that was fairly successful. We got all the shed off. It seemed to be, you know, obviously she was a little stressed, but I think some point during the middle there, she realized maybe he's just trying to help me, even though she's still not so sure about me. And, well, we got the shed off. She didn't have to make me draw blood, and hopefully that's one smaller step in getting her to really, really trust me, because I'd really like to take her out someday and just have her out like I do all my snakes, you know, but got a long road ahead of us. You're a good girl. I need you.